Well, it's a sort of a momentous night for me for a number of reasons. This is the 61st performance that we're presenting, that I am presenting at the Parish Museum. It is one of what got to be about 40 performances a year until COVID hit. Interestingly enough, it started about 25 years ago when I presented a duo pianist debut at Alice Tully Hall in Lincoln Center. One was my pianist, my son's music teacher, and the other one was the head of the music department at the UN school where he was. So I really loved doing that. I had been trained as a classical pianist as a kid. I'm not a classical pianist. Anyway, I then decided to join the board of the Music Festival of the Hamptons out here where we are. And at that particular place, my job was, of the 30 performances, there were 4, 5, or 6 pianists, and my part was to support those pianists. And part of the fundraising of the Hamptons Festival was an auction. And in that auction, you could bid on having a pianist come and play for a private party. I won Nadejda, who is going to perform tonight. Instead of having 2 or 3 or 4 people, I invited 40 people to my loft in Soho, which began a series of what we call salon performances, were 4, 5, 6 a year. Then I started performing in the gallery, which became the leading classical music venue in Soho. And then many other places, I joined Concert Artists Guild, ProMusicus, Piano Fest of the Hamptons, and it's been nothing but fun all this time. Nadejda was my beginning. Nadejda was with me all this time. We performed all over the world. We played with, or she's played with, the New World Symphony in Miami. I actually did a magnificent short subject, animated short subject film called Overture. And we actually had a chance at an Academy Award. We won a lot of awards at that. And if you can get to see Overture, you'll enjoy it. And now I am back again with Nadejda, who was my number one, got me started, and is with me here, and I present Nadejda Vlaeva.
Thank you, Lou. Hello, everybody. I'm really so happy to be here again. I have performed in this wonderful space, the Parish Museum, multiple times, and I can't wait when we're going to have concerts with live audience, and I'm going to meet you all in person. And for now, I'm going to perform my program this way, and this is also very exciting because I know that a lot of people from all over the world are watching and not sleeping. So I'm going to start with Scriabin Sonata number 2. According to the words of the composer, this sonata depicts a southern night by the seashore. So when the music becomes very dramatic, it depicts the agitated water of the ocean. When it's very gentle, it represents the soft moonlight playing on the waves. So in that, we can relate to the Beethoven Moonlight Sonata. And also, Beethoven did something revolutionary in his time. He started the Moonlight Sonata with a slow movement. And Scriabin did something similar. He started his sonata with a slow movement. He composed it only when he was in his 20s.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now this turbulent piece will be followed by a more quiet piece. I'm going to play Prelude number 4 from the set of 6 exotic preludes by Pancho Vladigerov, Bulgaria's most important classical music composer. He was born in 1899 and he lived till 1978. The set of preludes are composed in very interesting style, in Spanish style, for instance, in Slavic style, in Bulgarian style. This fourth one is composed in Arabic style. It's not as flamboyant as the other five. And it's also called Evening Song. So if you want to hear the rest of the set and some other pieces by Pancho Vladigerov, I invite you to listen to my newly issued CD by Hyperion Records.
Thank you.
So I know there were questions. People could ask questions on internet, and there's a one from Leslie Ackerman. Thank you, Leslie. He asks about my piece. Does the conception of a piece you compose evolve organically at the piano from an idea, musical cell, inspiration, or is it whole in a general way before you approach the piano? Well, usually I have melodies that are in my head, I guess cells, and I sit at the piano and all of a sudden they grow. And when I spend more and more time at the piano, they grow more and more and they lead to others. And so no, in the beginning, I don't know really know what it's going to be at the end. Rather, these are separate cells that and new ones are born and so on. It's a very interesting creative process. So the next piece is one of the most famous pieces composed by Liszt, Dreams of Love. And its piano version is so famous that we have completely forgotten that as original piece, it was composed for actually for voice and piano, and Liszt himself made a transcription for solo piano.
Thank you.
We continue with Liszt Sonata. This piece is my favorite work of Liszt. It has an immensely wide array of emotions, from heavenly angelic beauty to the sinister and the despair, from deep philosophy to religious tranquility. Really, the range is immense, a range that encompasses a whole life, human life. And this represents his multifaceted personality, from the virtuoso living life to the fullest, to the piano revolutionary, to the very generous altruistic persona, to Abelist, who lived in the Vatican in his latest years. He introduces in the beginning a few motifs, and they stay with us to the very end, but they transform immensely and go through many different emotional states.
Thank you. Thank you.
beyond spectacular, as always.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It's hard to come back here in this world because playing something like that is almost like an out-of-body experience.
It was incredible. And the next time that I will be presenting Nadejda will be the end of next year when I present all five Rachmaninoff concertos along with Pegasus, the orchestra in Lincoln Center. And Nadejda will be playing one of those concertos.
Thank you.
Thank you and good evening.